Hello, YouTube's Krosama, and here we have today is the Frame Arms Girl Stylet. Now this is a very unique coloring. It is actually from Phantasy Star Online 2, so it's actually a recolor from a mech from that game. This is the AIS color. Now, I don't really know much about the game, but I do know a lot about Frame Arms Girl, and they are badass. So let's just go ahead and jump into the unboxing. And with just taking a look at the cover art, I honestly think this looks super, super good. That's kind of what made me a little more attracted to it, is that bright red. Now, honestly, coming from a background of just building Gunpla, this definitely screams Char to me. So I was like, you know, I'm just gonna double down on the red, and sure enough, I'm gonna paint this kit red. And here we get front and rear shots of the kit, as well as a nice little action pose, just showing that it does come with a stand, and it's gonna have a nice little sword there for a melee weapon. And for the collaboration, you can see the mech right behind Skylet, and that's basically just going to be the color palette of the mech. So, looks really good. I actually really like the blue that's kind of like, you know, sprinkled all around the kit, like on the skirt and the chest armor. But yeah, I'm pretty stoked to build this, and I don't know if I'm going to keep the blue. It looks really good, but I might turn that into a different color. However, we will see. And as far as faces, you're going to get a wide range of different expressions. So, actually a lot more than what I initially remember, because I bought this kit, I want to say about 9 or 10 months ago, actually when I first got here to Japan, and this was possibly the second or third Frame Arms Girl kit I bought. I just never got around to painting it, so I didn't really realize that this is going to have so many different facial expressions, which I love all four of them. And here is a sample photo of the unpainted kit. And here you are going to be getting water slide decals, so that is a huge, huge plus. And this kit supposedly is supposed to retail at 4,800 yen, but I'm pretty sure that is the price for the regular stylet. This kit is definitely going to go up for a little bit more. However, I did pay about, actually around that same exact price, but you know, here in Japan, things are going to be a little bit cheaper. And looking at the first runner, which is going to be runner A, you're going to get a lot of the flesh color. So pretty much going to be for your legs, the gut, you know, the body, neck, wrists, and so on and so forth. Next is going to be runner B, which is a pink color for the hair. Next is going to be runner C, so this entire runner is going to be red. So pretty much all for the armor and a little bit of the backpack right there. Next is going to be two runner D's, which is another red, so you got some of the fins right there for the legs and just other parts of the armor. This is going to be runner E. This is going to have like the little stockings and the fixed leg for, you know, that little infamous pose. Next is going to be two runner F's. These are going to be black runners, and they're going to be for your joints as well as the feet. Runner G, this is going to be a kind of like dark gray, but this is gonna be a lot for the armor pieces that just kind of like breaks up the color of the red. Next you're gonna have is runner H, so this is gonna be parts for the skirt as well as more for the joints, but this is another black runner. Runner I, which is a very nice brown, and like you see right there, it's gonna have that pre-colored blue, which is very, very bright, but yeah, this is just gonna be more armor parts. And runner J, you're going to have two of these, which is going to be the same exact brown. So this is just going to be more for the armor. Two runner K's, which is going to be that dark gray as well. So this looks like it's going to be more for the joints. And you get the same exact runner K's, but this one's going to be molded in white. Runner L is going to be molded in white as well, but this is going to be for the panties, as well as just some of the other more girly aesthetics. Runner M being just flesh color parts. And runner N, this is going to be that dark gray as well. So this looks like it's going to be a lot for the weaponry. You got the missiles, you got thrusters right there, and just some other little armor and weapon parts, as you can see. Another runner I, which is going to be for the stand. And you get two katanas with the sheaths, and they're going to have pretty nice details, but unfortunately you will have to paint these. Your standard polycap sheet, and the large variety of facial expressions, which are going to be pre-colored as well. And a large array of hands, so that way you can, you know, easily assess all these different accessories, as well as kind of more personalize your Frame Arms Girl. A beautiful water slide decal sheet, so you're gonna have different eyes right there. So whenever I do paint the faces, I can just, you know, reapply all these eyes, and it's gonna look just as good. Now all this white, I'm definitely gonna use this as well, because I do think they look pretty damn good. And lastly is going to be the instruction manual. So we're not really seeing too much of a uniqueness in this. It's going to be a lot like the other Frame Arms Girl. So over here you do have your illustrations, you got your list of runners. Looks like it's just marking out some of the runners that you're, some of the parts that you're not going to be using in these runners, which is always a great thing to just get, kind of prepped on, especially if you're going to cut all the parts out first. But yeah, the instructions are going to be very simple, and I'm definitely going to go ahead and pretty much do like a straight build. I'm not going to do anything extra work wise to it, so I'll straight build it. I'm not going to do this little section where she's kind of holding the stocking. Not very interested in that. I'm only going to build one of the katanas. I don't think both of them are going to be necessary. But yeah, I'm pretty much going to build this up, do a little review for y'all, and that should be about it. Now I don't think I've mentioned this in the beginning of this review, but I am, well, actually I did, I know I didn't, but I'm doing this ahead of a lot of Gunpla kits and a lot of other projects I have. Especially, I'm not gonna play Kingdom Hearts at least for a little bit until I can get a good foot into the door of building this and painting it, because I'm doing this for the Zucca Aurealis contest. And I'll go ahead and I'll link it in the description down below where you can go ahead and see his video, and if you decide you want to participate in the contest as well, you definitely can. But I just figured I really wanted to paint this kit, about 10 months ago, so probably now is the best time to go ahead and just customize it, paint it, and put some work into it for the contest. And whether I win or lose, I think I'm gonna have a really nice kit, to display on my shelf. Debating, if I really want to stick with the colors I originally intended, which was going to be a pretty dark maroon, much like this. This is like more brown to me, but I was gonna have a very dark red, which to me it was looking a little bit more maroon, and then a very bright candy red for the armor. So I don't know if I'm still gonna do that, but if I do, I do. If I don't, I don't. And I think having more of a candy coated red, and then having more dull colors for the other parts, I think is gonna look pretty damn good. But that could be just me, so I'm not really too sure. We'll try and see how it works. If it doesn't work out, oh well. If it does, then awesome. But yeah, other than that, guys, definitely thank you for watching. Oh wait, actually, before we go, so let me go over exactly what I'm going to do. I almost forgot about this. But yeah, I bought some MSG parts. This one, it looks so weird. At first, I really wasn't, thinking too much into it when I was kind of contemplating what I was going to use. But then looking on the back, there's the original stylet right here. And bam, she utilizes these as wings. And I was like, oh my God. I was like, this kind of reminded me of Ant-Man and the Wasp. For whatever reason. So I was like, this looks super good, and I'm just basically gonna steal this idea. I'm probably gonna invert this, so I'm gonna have like the long side. I wanna try and have that upwards, kind of like how it's shown right here, where the more longer wing is up and then the shorter wing is down. And to kind of like do a little bit extra, I was thinking of like cutting out some clear film, like maybe some green film, and then just draw on it like a dragonfly wing. Maybe like just have a single one coming out right here, and just like, draw the little lines and everything, like kind of like the honeycomb kind of look, and basically attach it into somewhere around here as like an effect part. I think that would probably be cool, but that's just kind of like in my head, and I would really love to kind of put that in motion. But yeah, this is going to be one of the things I'm using, exactly how it's displayed on the back of the packaging. And next is going to be this long rifle. So I was like, you know what, this is going to be an aerial suit, so why not just give it this huge, huge rifle? I think it looks really cool. It's just, I don't know, like I looked at it and I was like, you know what, I'm kind of a fan of giant, rifles. Something that's just way more oversized of the actual mobile suit that's wielding it. So I think this is going to look pretty damn good. And just looking at the height from a regular Frame Arms frame, I think the Frame Arms Girl are generally about the same size as the frame itself. So I was like, this is going to be super, super awesome. And yeah, definitely going to go ahead and utilize this, try and paint it multiple colors and layers, and just do my best. I have a month and a half to complete this project, so I'm hoping I can do good behind this. Okay, and next is going to be this big boy set. So this is another MSG set, number 18 in a line. And it's, looking at the front, it's like, oh, it's just a backpack. So I was kind of examining it, looking at it, just kind of like going through here. But then I came across over to this part. So once again, they're utilizing the style lid. I'm like, okay, cool. But then I see right here, you can go ahead and attach it to the legs. And I was like, oh my God, like I want to utilize these, like basically replace the stylet's legs. Take this bottom half of the leg off and replace it with this and have like, you know, basically the same color separation as the leg right here to right here. So having like this little line part be that darker red and then just the brighter red going down here with all the white. So I'm looking forward to this, and I might still be able to attach the fins on the side of here, which will just be super, super baller. I'm just loving the ideas I have that are flowing, and I don't know. I really just have a lot of ideas for this. But yeah, those are pretty much going to be all the custom parts I'm going to add to this kit. And before we break, I just got this one last thing, which is the session bass. So I bought this actually alongside the Skylet, and it's basically just a little bass for the Frame Arms girls. So I think it looks pretty cool. The one thing I'm just probably not going to have is going to be these little side railings. I think it's cool, but I'm going to take these off, and you know, she's going to have you know, a couple of pictures taken for the contest. So one of the pictures is going to be her standing and just going to have the rifle, you know, just standing up along with her. And I think it's just going to be cool to have her in a very neutral kind of face, just a very standard pose. And then another one is going to be with the stand and her just kind of being more aerial, maybe even like launching or something, or firing the rifle. But ultimately, you know, from the anime, I might actually take another watch of the anime just to kind of get some better ideas of what I want to do. But yeah, I think the stand looks pretty damn good. I think everything I have as far as ideas is very solid. So next is going to be just the building process, doing a test fit. I'll show you how the test fit as well, because I'm probably going to do this in little parts. But yeah, other than that, guys, just want to show you what's my plan. Probably don't expect me to do much of Gunpla. I'm gonna try and do smaller Gunpla kits and just straight build to review, and then I got other pose videos I'll upload. But yeah, this is gonna be my project for the next month and a half. So hopefully I can finish this before the birth of a good old Hero-kun. But wish me luck, guys, and I'll be seeing y'all in the next video. Bye-bye.